Greetings, everyone. The book of Revelation tells us that there was a recent war in heaven in this end time. Now, I believe that we can prove to you that that was just a little over 28 years ago. And I say that because of a specific individual who lived and has since died. But we have booklets to show this to you more clearly and give you more details on that. But this is truly something that sounds outrageous to a lot of people, but it's right there in your Bible. It's right there in the scriptures in your Bible, and you can prove it, most of them coming from the New Testament. So they're available to us. If we closely study that war, you will see that Satan, as in his worst wrath, he's in a mad frenzy because of something he knows that many people on this earth doesn't know. He knows that he is about to be removed from his rule on this earth and his influence on this earth and replaced by Jesus Christ himself. He knows that that time is almost here. Now, many events on this earth are happening because of that war. And what does it mean to you? It's going to affect you and every single individual on this earth. And I mean in a dramatic way, according to your own Bible. You don't need to take my word for it, and you never should take my word for it. But you can take God's word for it, and you can prove what that word is. So these words may sound strange, but you have to remember that the book of Revelation says in the very first verse that God is going to reveal these things to his servants of that which is shortly going to come to pass. And it's almost solely focused on the end time. So let's take a look at that war in Revelation 12 and verse 7. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought and his angels, or his demons now, fallen angels. Verse 8 says, and prevail not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. So Michael and his angels fought, and they won that war and cast Satan and the demons down to this earth. And now they're confined to this earth and not even able to go back out into the universe at all. I mean, we're talking about millions and millions of demons and Satan himself cast down to this earth, evil beings. And can you imagine what they might be doing on this earth? You don't have to look around too far to see that, I think. But it says in Romans 8 that the whole universe is groaning and travailing in pain, waiting for the sons of God to free them from their bondage. That bondage that was caused by Satan's rebellion two different times, but in particular, the one in this end time caused a lot of damage.